guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and today I have the pleasure of showing you 6 more cheap acoustic guitars that don't suck. From what I can see in the comments of the last video, you guys really enjoyed it, and I hope that it helped you on your musical journey with your first amazing beginner acoustic guitar. There's a few more brands out now, like this lovely East Coast, and you guys suggested some amazing suggestions in the comments of the last video, so here I am with the follow-up. 6 more cheap acoustic guitars that don't suck. We've got offerings from, like I said, East Coast, Tanglewood, Washburn, Alvarez. I'm gonna talk you through them all, some of the specs and features, some of the quirks, all playing through this fantastic Aston Stealth microphone, Tuatec cables, and me, Dagan. That's enough talking, let's get into it with this. This is the fantastic East Coast D1. And this guitar is well under 100 quid. It is an amazing looking, feeling, and sounding guitar. As you can see, it's a dreadnought shape, which I always call like a Swiss Army guitar shape. Not too big, so it's not just for strumming, not too small, so it's not just a fingerstyle picking, it's the perfect shape for every variant, and a great beginner guitar. Laminate spruce top, Sapelli back and sides with lovely binding, lovely bridge with an etched little bird here. So it's kind of East Coast thing, this bird. It's laser etched there, laser etched on the headstock, and inside there's the laser etched East Coast logo as well. Mahogany neck, lovely round C-shaped neck. That's my C-shaped neck song. And yeah, it's fantastic. Got black tuners. It kind of just looks very sleek and very sexy with a satin finish as well. With satin, I always try and get people onto the whole satin train, because when you're playing it and your hand gets a little bit warm and sweaty, especially if you're beginning, it's all new to you and you're nervous standing in front of your mirror trying to be Bob Dylan and that. Your hand just kind of glides over the satin. And when it does start to get shiny, it molds to your hand. So it will get shiny after a while, but it'll be in the shape of your palm, which is very, very nice, and it'll make it easier for you to play. So I think that's all the specs on this guy. Let's see how she sounds some more. What I'm finding more and more as well these days, working in a guitar store, and the term laminate, it's quite an ugly word when it comes to tone woods. It has to be solid wood to make it sound good. That is useless information from the past. Maybe 20, 30 years ago, laminate kind of sucked, but now we're in an age where laminate wood sounds just as good in tone wood, in my humble opinion. If you think I'm wrong, destroy me in the comments down below. But with laminate wood, it's robust and it's not really affected by temperature and humidity like solid wood is. So if you leave this in a cold house and take it to a warm stage, it's not gonna change, it's not gonna warp, it's not gonna sound any different. The longevity and the tone of this will last a very long time. Those are some specs and sounds on the amazing East Coast D1. I believe it comes in a satin sunburst finish as well. So let me know what you think. Would you want something nice and natural for your first guitar, or something a bit flashy like a sunburst? This is the Tanglewood TWJDS, and the reason it's one of my favourite budget-friendly acoustic guitars is because it's made out of exotic tonewoods. Tonewoods. The top of this TWJDS is, as you'd expect, a spruce top, because spruce sounds fantastic for every kind of variant of acoustic guitar playing. But the back and sides is where it gets interesting. This is a Mara Ebony back and sides with a spalted mango centerpiece. And I've never spalted a mango before, and mango sounds amazing when you say it in a jolly accent, like I've just realized. But isn't that beautiful? Such an amazing guitar with amazing tone woods for not a lot of money. If that kind of wood was in a Taylor or a PRS acoustic guitar, the price would be through the roof. But because it's Tanglewood, an amazing company which know how to source these woods and put them in guitars for not a lot of money, it isn't a lot of money. Besides that though, this thing sounds fantastic. It's a dreadnought body shape, so the kind of Swiss Army guitar, like I've said before, strums really well, does fingerstyle stuff really well. You kind of can't go wrong with a dreadnought, and it's super comfy as well. Mahogany neck, and it's got a Techwood fingerboard and bridge. Doesn't quite say what Techwood is online. Comment down below if you know what Techwood is. It is just an environmentally sourced wood, so I'm guessing it's like an amalgamation of lots of offcuts of wood heat pressed together to be sustainable and to not kill the rainforest, and being that chimpanzees and all that that live in the rainforest. One little fun thing I enjoy are the open back tuners as well. Again, this isn't an expensive guitar, but the quality, aesthetically and tonally, is just phenomenal. And I think that is all the specs. You can hear a little rock, and that's a silica gel pack that's inside to keep it nice and fresh for when you buy it. But yeah, let's hear how she sounds. This is a D chord, G chord. And if you're one of the guys out there thinking the tonewood doesn't really affect guitars, whether you're watching this video by itself with the Tanglewood or part of the five more cheap acoustic guitars that don't suck video, I'm playing guitars back to back, and you can definitely tell the difference with certain tonewoods, which is why I highly recommend coming into one of our PMT stores as opposed to just, well, buying online is great if you know what you want, but if you really want to find something that's right for you, you'd never think of buying a Mara Ebony guitar. So come in and try one out, I highly recommend it. Try not to play. So that's it, I think, all the quirks and features of the amazing Tanglewood TWJDS. Again, a guitar that doesn't cost a lot, but has some fantastic wood on it. Look at that. I wonder how many mangoes were spalted to make that centerpiece. This is a Washburn HD20S, and this is an amazingly beautiful, versatile guitar for a number of reasons. Firstly, my favorite being solid spruce top paired with rosewood back and sides, so it's super clear and super articulate. Solid spruce, so it's going to sound better the more you play it and the older it gets. You get to be there at the beginning with your brand new Washburn HD20S and play it in to your favorite songs. And rosewood back and sides, nice and snappy sounding wood. Look at it, it's lovely. Cream binding as well. When you get the dark wood with the cream binding, it just looks elegant and very tuxedo-esque, in my humble opinion. Lovely, comfy C-shape mahogany neck. It's a gloss finish with satin on the back of the neck, like I said before. Satin's always good because your hand doesn't really stick to it, especially when you're beginning. Your hand might get a little bit clammy and sweaty. With a satin neck, it just smooths, it slides right over its smooth surface. Rosewood fingerboard, rosewood bridge, lovely tortoiseshell scratch plate. Dreadnought shape, so it suits every kind of playing style. Cracking headstock on the new Washburns, isn't it? They kind of went for the nice little yellowy wood Washburn logo with a little decal in the middle. Ebonite buttons as well. Diecast tuners. Ebonite buttons, which I assume is something to do with ebony. Yeah. Bound fingerboard. 20 of Washburn's finest frets. And this is how it sounds. One thing I do enjoy, but it seems to irritate some beginners, is the fact that the strap button, there's no strap button on this side of the neck, so you can't wear it like a traditional guitar. You've got to get a piece of string, which does come on most straps, and put it on the headstock. It's Johnny Cash, man. It's Elvis Presley. It's how they used to do it back in the day before they weren't drilled into their lovely washburn guitars. I think it's great and adds a lot of character to a beautiful guitar. So that is the Washburn HD20S, a beautiful guitar with some amazing specs for not a lot of money. What's your ideal acoustic guitar of choice? Spruce and rosewood? Spruce and mahogany? Spruce and sapelli? Totally mahogany, a cedar top. There's so many options out there. Let me know down below in the old commentos. This is a Fender FA-125. I love the FA-125 solely because it brings joy to so many people. It's a new, I'm gonna say staple in Fender's lineup of affordable acoustic guitars, and everyone seems to gravitate towards these guitars because it has Fender on the headstock and it plays and sounds great. It lights up so many lives getting your first acoustic guitar, and the FA-125 is now definitely up there because they're so easy to play and they sound great. Spruce top, mahogany back and sides. It's kind of like a no-frills acoustic guitar in the best possible way. Buy it, strum it, sound good. Mahogany neck with a probably thinner than usual, more electric guitar shaped neck, which is easier to get your fingers around. And the fingerboard radius, if you don't know what that is, it's the curvature of the fingerboard, is 12 inches. Higher it is, the flatter it is. And this has a very flat fingerboard. So for me, predominantly an electric guitar player, this guitar fits very, very nice. Not that you can, I suppose you could shred on it, if you wanted to, but it's a flat fingerboard. Rosewood fingerboard at that, and a rosewood bridge. It is set off beautifully as well with the black binding up the neck and on the back. Diecast tuners, great guitar. And this is how she sounds. I kind of want to play electric riffs on it now because it's got a very electric feeling neck. Now, I'm not going to play all of that, that'd be ridiculous. So there we have it, guys, some specs and sounds on the amazing Fender FA-125. A budget-friendly guitar that looks and sounds fantastic and says Fender on the headstock. This is an Epiphone Hummingbird Pro. And if you're looking for an iconic guitar on a budget, this is the one you should go for. Epiphone have brought that classic 1960s Hummingbird back to the 21st century, that classic bluesy rock icon for the modern player. I always think of Keith Richards when I see these iconic guitars. Songs like Satisfaction, Under My Thumb, Play With Fire, all Hummingbirds. And now you can get one for not a lot of money. It's the usual Hummingbird specs you've all come to know and love. Spruce top, mahogany back and sides, mahogany neck. This features Epiphone's E-Performance preamp system. So there's a two-band EQ, bass, treble, volume control, a mute switch, and a phase button if there's ever any unwanted noise. But for the sake of this video, I'm going through the Aston Stealth to give you an idea of what the guitar itself sounds like. It's got a slim taper, D-profile mahogany neck, 20 of Epiphone's finest frets on a rosewood fingerboard, lovely big Epiphone headstock, and one of my favorite features, the Hummingbird tortoiseshell scratch plate. People often confuse these with the doves as well. If you don't know the difference between a Hummingbird and a dove is a spruce top with a maple back and sides. The Hummingbird is mahogany back and sides. 24¾-inch scale, 12-inch radius fingerboard, and this is an A chord. And that 12-inch fingerboard radius does make it very easy to do single note stuff as opposed to the whole. So that was the Epiphone Hummingbird Pro, a fantastic legendary guitar that brought back for the 21st century. Thank you, Epiphone. Who's your favorite Hummingbird player? Like me, Keith Richards, or not? Let me know down below in the comments. This fantastic little beast is the Alvarez AF30CE. I'm not going to go too in-depth with this guitar because our lovely Sam already has a video of it going in-depth with all the woods and sounds, so check that out on the PMTV UK YouTube channel. So I'll just quickly nip over it because I think it's amazing. Solid A-grade spruce top, mahogany back and sides, mahogany neck. This is a folk body shape, so it's a little bit smaller, a little bit brighter, a little bit snappier, but it's very easy to work around, especially when it has the cutaway here. Get up to the dusty end. This is the only guitar in this little six more cheap acoustic guitars that don't suck series where you can get up to the dusty end and for not a lot of money. It has a preamp as well, 3-band EQ with a presence control, volume, and a built-in tuner, all of Alvarez's own design. Techwood fingerboard and bridge, again, that's sustainable wood that is used to help save the rainforest, essentially. Alvarez are doing a very good job of that because there's still rainforest. Anyways, those are some specs. Here are some quick sounds. Notice how I'm not plugging it in, I'm using it with the Aston Stealth to give you a level playing field with these acoustic guitars. You do get a great snap from a smaller body guitar, especially when it's got a solid spruce top. So because it's one of my favorites, I thought I'd put this amazing Alvarez AF30CE in. But like I said, check out Sam's video. It's amazing. He goes in depth with it with much more precise playing than my little sore fingers. Anyways, I think that's it. Five, six of what I believe to be more of the best value acoustic guitars that certainly don't suck. What was your favorite? I really enjoyed that Epiphone, just for the kind of caliber of it. But I'm a fan of the FA1252. I don't know. I like the Epiphone. Epiphone's good. Let me know down below what you like and why you like it. I always like knowing why people enjoy things. And if there's any more acoustic guitars that we haven't covered, again, comment, because we might get a third installment of this video and end up with every budget guitar under the sun being played by my manky little Geordie fingers. Anyways, if you liked this video, smash the like button and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the lovely guitars I've covered here today, go to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding beautiful PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see lots of pictures of these guys, but with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I shall see you next time